Like to put up few figures and statistics of the participation and something about the expert speaker and so on. So today what happened was we have received total of 183 registered participation for participation, and we have solicited around 140, and of that we got a confirmation of 96. And finally, we had some figure like 33 faculty participated and 39 students participated. Together, we had 72 figures in figure. And for the online exam, there are 54 of them who turn up today. Now, regarding the participation, we had participation from across the country, from various institutions and from the resource organizations. And regarding the speaker, we had altogether 12 speaker, expert speakers, and of that, three are from the foreign universities, and then there are three from the industry expert, and six of them are Indian speakers. Now, we would like to have some feedback from the participants. If possible, we would like to have one or two feedback from the faculty and one or two feedback from the students. Is there anyone who wants to share any kind of feedback from this participation? Sindhukuri Mallikarjuna, would you like to share something? Are there anyone who wants to share something?
Hello.
Yes, please share something.
Yes. I would like to show my appreciation for the organizing team. They have actually done a very commendable task for organizing this event, and in fact, most of the schedules, most of the talk and the sessions has been exactly on schedule. That is really appreciated. And I also like to thank all the resource person. I think this workshop has been very resourceful and informative to me. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you. Are there some more who wants to give some feedback? Who wants to share the experience? Setan Nagrawal, will you like to share some of your experience? Please. Please unmute your mic, Setan, please. Please unmute your mic, yes.
Before the starting of this workshop, I was not having any idea about the deep learning and the neural network. But now I have some experience and I can work on that. And especially I am working on the machine translation field. So I was thinking to use the deep learning techniques to involve in the machine translation. So there, from this purpose, I have obtained some knowledge. So it was a nice workshop.
Okay, thank you. Are there some more who wants to share the experience? Eduri Raza.
Yes, this workshop, in this workshop I learned so many things. Actually, till now I have some doubt whether in the fake news detection we have to use machine translation or not. In the workshop I clarified that one. In the workshop I learned so many things, sir. Thank you for the organizing committee. Thank you, sir.
Okay, so are there some more who wants to share the experience? Anyone from our institute, from NIT Silchar, anybody who wants to share the experience? Dipali, would you like to share something? Okay, if there is no one now, may I request respected director Sir Fu to share a few words about this event?
Very good evening to my colleagues at NIT Silchar and other participants, colleagues and research scholars and students to the faculty development program on recent advances in NLP using the deep learning techniques. Now, first of all, I would like to share with you that maybe there is the kind of timing we normally think of. That is, every day such a week-long program will start at the same time and will finish at the same time. But because of the time difference across the different parts of the world, so some of the lectures had to be set at such a time, sometimes say later in the evening. So that might have made the participation of some of the people really difficult. But these kind of timing adjustments are going to be the thing for the future. That is, some of the talks on some days can be early morning, some can be late night. They say the mid-evening kind of thing. So in that way, that is, the world is taking an united direction to move forward. The second part, what I want to share with you, obviously, all of us being present in online and not being able to share the physical existence or physical presence of each of us. So obviously, if in future the situation permits, so there is an open invitation to all of you, at least to make a visit to NIT Silchar. Say we'll have different kinds of programs. We are organizing one workshop in the next week also on the recent advances in machine translation, because we have an Indo-German Spark program, and as part of that, there are say our German collaborator and other German speakers. And then we have other speakers from the different corners of the world also. So as you have seen, that is, obviously we were working at an international level earlier, but what we see that is, the current pandemic situation has given all of us the scope to work in a more in an international collaborative environment. And later in the year, in the month of December, the dates are not yet fixed, not yet finalized, but we'll have the International Conference on Natural Language Processing, which is famously known as the ICON. So ICON 2021 will be held at NIT Silchar. And obviously, with the kind of, say, the initiation of work or the whatever the research activities you are carrying out, we do hope that during that period, you will be able to submit your research articles there. And at NIT Silchar, in 2019, we organized one conference, Big Data and Machine Learning, in abbreviation, Big DML. So all of you, those who are present, those who could not be present at this point of time, all of you are invited to that program as well. Now, at NIT Silchar, that is, if we look into the aspects of the national education policy, that is, the basic facets of education policy, is obviously research and innovation. And long before that, say, at NIT Silchar, we are pursuing the path of research and innovation. And when you talk about research, we do not mean that research only in the terms of, say, the patents or research paper publications, but we thrust on the translational research. So request to all of you who are pursuing research at various levels, all of them may not be the ardent follower of NLP or working in the NLP area, but whatever research activities you do, you make it a point that is translated into a product, into a system, so that reaches the society, it reaches the mankind. And by research, let us also mean that research is basically collaborative in nature. You cannot do research singly sitting in your laboratory. You need to have collaborations within your institute, then across the institute, within the region, within the country, across the globe also. And you must have seen that. That is in our research lab, say my earlier assignment and here also. We are in the research domain of natural language processing for a long time, not only within the country, but across the globe as well. And this is the path I will request all of you to basically follow. The research are interdisciplinary in nature, and the very interdisciplinary nature of NLP is obviously evident with all of you, because say the language and the computers, so obviously this is one of the two broad pillars of interdisciplinary nature. Then internationalization is obviously another aspect. And when you talk about language, and in the national education policy, you must have seen that there is the thrust on the Indian languages is one of the pivoting pillars of the national education policy. And through our activities in the NLP, so we also are oriented towards promotion of Indian languages in the computational aspects, basically. And industry also plays a crucial role. And though in our these faculty development program, say we had representatives from the industry as well, from say Microsoft Research, or say we had from the Wipro AI Lab, then Samsung Research, SRI Bangalore. So we have tried to give you the flavor that what actually need to be followed or what we were following. And that is, you must have didn't notice, that is just a 2 days ago, NIT Silchar has also been ranked in the Times Higher Education Emerging Economies World University Ranking 2021. Now, when we look into these rankings, it basically, we want to identify our strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, as well as the challenges that lie before us. Because we, as an institute, we want to proceed to the next level. And that applies to all of you. That is, say, from your current position, when you want to move to the next level, next steps, always analyze your strengths, your weaknesses, your opportunities, and the challenges that you see ahead. And when your analysis is basically across these four pillars, then your progress, your development to the next level will be successful. So that as far as the success of the faculty development program, 5 days long, when you want to measure that, it is not only measured by the attendance of how many people attended that, how many scholars, how many faculties, who are the resource persons, but most importantly, the success actually lies what is going to happen in the future. Who among you, how are you taking up, that is any relationship that you might have developed with the resource persons, with the organizers like us, so that we all together can work for natural language processing, involving Indian languages more specifically, but in general, with the different aspects of natural language processing. With this, I wish the program, the FDP, has been a grand success. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your inspiring words. Now I would like to welcome Dr. Doran, sir, to kindly say a few words.
Doran.
Okay, sir, my network got disconnected. Thank you, sir, for your encouraging words. And I would like to thank once again the participants for participating in this event. And I would like to see you soon with the workshop that we are going to have next week. If some of you have registered, if it is already there, fine. If you have not registered and you want to start working with the machine translation, please register. The link is still available with our institute website. And hope to see you next week. And with these few words, I would like to thank once more to all the speakers, to all the participants, and each and everyone who make this particular event a successful one. Thank you. With this, I would like to close this event faculty development program on NLP using deep learning. Thank you each and everyone for your participation.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so we can leave the meeting then.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.